I've already made a couple of videos about different After Effects alternatives and received multiple suggestions regarding software I didn't cover yet. One of those programs is Friction. So I've tested it and it is definitely an interesting piece of software which rethinks a lot of the creative processes you're used to from other applications. Some highlights you can look forward to in this video are procedural vector graphics, Blender hotkeys, good performance, and an interesting approach to a layer-based timeline. Friction is a free open-source software specializing in the creation of motion graphics for video and web. You can animate text and vector graphics, but also add raster graphics like images or videos. When comparing it with After Effects, Friction definitely focuses more on the animation aspect of it rather than the compositing features. You could do some basic compositing in Friction currently, but you will notice that it isn't the use case it has been built for. Friction is a fork of the open source animation software Envy, which hasn't received any activity in the last years. But Friction isn't really meant to be a revival of the project. It uses Envy as a base for the code, but pursues its own vision. You can download Friction for Windows, Linux, and macOS with Intel CPUs. On the page, you will see two downloads. I recommend you to pick the latest version, which is the one with the higher number. Currently, it's still in version 1.1.1, so it is still at an early stage. Just keep that in mind during the video. Let's talk about the actual experience in Friction. It launches really fast. Basically, you just open it and instantly get to the UI. Speaking of the UI, its structure is rather simple and almost feels kinda empty. This will probably change a lot in the future when more features are being added. When it comes to creating vector graphics, Friction offers the most basic tools. You can create basic shapes, draw paths, and also merge them or use them for operations you might know from Illustrator's Path Tracer. If you want to animate complex vector graphics in Friction, create the vectors in another software. No, seriously, this is also what's currently recommended in the documentation, and I agree. If you only wanted to add text or basic shapes, you can exclusively rely on using the vector tools of Friction, but for logos or vector art, you should use a more dedicated tool like Affinity Designer or Inkscape, and then export your work to use it in Friction. For example, I couldn't figure out how to force the pen tool to create a straight line. It didn't snap to the axis of already existing points, holding shift or control while using the pen tool did nothing, and I also weren't able to straighten it afterwards by setting the scale of one axis to zero. Which brings me to another point, Blender hotkeys. Just like in graphite, you can use G, R and S to transform your selection. You can also enter numbers or lock the transformation on a specific axis. Just like in Blender, you can confirm with left click and cancel the action with right click. But right click is also binded to panning in the view. So you have to make sure to keep your mouse steady in order for Friction to register it correctly. Which is a bit annoying when the button you have to press is on the object you have to hold steady. But speaking of, when you right click on the object, you also get an option to center the pivot point. Which, by the way, you can move by just dragging it using the selection tool. Apparently, you can also make it work without using an extra tool. Just like in Blender, you can also reset the transformation using Alt in combination with G, R and S. Those hotkeys are pretty cool, but I'm not a fan of all the other shortcuts. For example, the hotkeys for the tools are on the F keys. Those aren't suitable for actions that are that basic. They are hard to reach, and some keyboards don't even have them. There are also some similar issues where the hotkeys are not from any other softwares, didn't work. For example, holding Alt and dragging a selection doesn't duplicate it, I can only use the Del key to delete objects and not backspace, and I couldn't rename objects pressing F2. There are also some positive examples for the hotkeys, like navigating through frames using the arrow keys, or opening a search using Ctrl and space. Also, the overall navigation works pretty much like expected. The hotkey for inserting a keyframe is mapped to the insert key, which makes sense, but I don't have it on my keyboard. And currently, there are no settings for remapping hotkeys. But Friction not only has hotkeys, it also has cool keyframes. Like you would expect, you can create and organize keyframes in Friction. Overall, it already works quite well. but the button next to each keyframeable value doesn't work like you would expect. When you press it, it will create a keyframe of the value on the current frame. But if you would move forward and press it again, you will delete all currently created keyframes. So this button won't insert keyframes, it will just enable keyframes for this value overall and record the value. So if you would change the value while the button is toggled, it will automatically create a keyframe. But this is probably a quite easy fix to make in a future update. The Blender hotkeys also work in the keyframe editor. You can move the keyframes using them, but also scale them relative to the timeline marker, which is pretty cool. If you combine the hotkeys with the input of numbers, you can perform precise actions like moving a keyframe exactly 4 frames forward or double the distance between 2 keyframes. Sadly, I'm a bit disappointed how the interpolations and animation curves have been implemented. To make a value show up in the animation curves, you have to expand it in the timeline and then click on the value first. And adjusting the curves also doesn't feel too good. It's okay, but I've definitely seen better, but also worse. At least it's quite easy to get to the curve editor. The interpolations, however, are very weird. From other software, I am used to selecting the first keyframe, right-clicking, and then choosing an interpolation. In Friction, you select the start and the end keyframe, and then go to this panel here to select an interpolation. I guess the thought behind this is that you can select an unlimited amount of keyframes and select an interpolation that is mapped over all of them. What confused me even more is that some interpolations will add more keyframes to your timeline than before, and just switching to another interpolation won't make them go away. However, I was able to work with the animation tools in Friction, but I definitely encountered better ones before. Where it gets really interesting, however, is when you take a look at the effects for vector graphics. Those effects allow you to procedurally change the look of your vector graphics. They reminded me of Blender's modifier stack, as some of the available effects seem similar or have familiar names and are also applied from top to bottom. There are a lot of different effects you can achieve with them, and they feel quite easy to use while being very powerful at the same time. You can control dashes, displace your vectors, trim your paths, create a zigzag shading-like effect, control arrays, and more. What I did miss, however, was a simple evolution value to animate each effect. But yes, you can keyframe the values of those effects. Where it gets a bit more complicated is that each effect exists in 4 variations. Because you can apply them to the path, the fill, the outline base, and the outline. You're probably wondering what the difference between both outline effects is. Yeah, I'm not so sure either. It feels like outline base is the actual outline you define in the stroke settings, and outline is something different. You can also copy and paste the effects to other objects. It just feels a bit clunky because you will need to add the effect to the other object first and then paste it. So basically, you're copy and pasting the settings and not the effect itself. One thing Friction is missing in my opinion is that you can't taper the thickness of strokes. In tutorials I could see that Envy had this feature, but it has been removed. I don't know why, but I would guess it caused some deeper issues. To make those vector effects even more procedural, you can use expressions to animate them. The expression editor opens in a separate window and feels closer to actual programming than in other softwares. But Friction comes with a list of presets, so you can also make use of it when not being a programmer. And you can also add custom presets, which are synced between projects. For example, I created a preset for a jitter effect, so the value only changes every few frames. So basically, just making the value use a lower frame rate. I would say you pretty much get the experience you would expect, but with more custom variables. Creating text in Friction works quite alright, I would say. Again, I've seen better and worse. What kinda bugs me is not having a preview of the fonts in the font browser. Also, some fonts didn't work for some reason. I checked if it's an issue with the type of file, but other fonts that are in the same format worked. So yeah, I don't know what's going on. Computers, am I right? For my brothers across the globe, I also want to note that you can enable RTL support in Friction settings. Animating text works in a pretty interesting way, because you can use the text effect to animate individual characters. Basically, it will create a movable and editable sloped shape. This will control the range and falloff of the animation. You can specify what happens when the ladder is in the range by using the transform sliders in the effect. What's even more interesting is that you can also add path effects, which will make use of the falloff. So you can technically create a stylized invisibility effect by making all lines within the range use dashes. The tool works quite intuitive once you figured it out, but there is one major thing I found quite annoying. Since you don't use keyframes for the transformation of your ladders, but for the position of the slope, you can't really influence the values for the letters with interpolations. And I personally like to add some amount of anticipation and overshooting to these kind of animations, which in this case isn't possible using interpolations. I did come up with some kind of workaround. The Y position of each slope point controls the strength of the animation. The Y positions are limited to 0 and 1, so I couldn't use negative 1. Instead, I made it work by setting the start and end of the slope to 0.5 and the other points to 0 and 1. So, it is a versatile tool, but also has some limitations currently. But I guess that might be fixed with future updates. Friction really has a quite unique way how it handles layers, which can definitely lead to some confusion. Every object you create will be stacked like it's on its own layer, but like at the same time they're not really layers, because you can select multiple objects, put them in a group, and then gain the ability to promote them to a layer. I think they might want to rename that to something more distinctive. I guess it's probably a leftover from Envy. If you're wondering why you would want to promote a group to a layer, it's because you can use masks exclusively on layers. What's very cool is that you can add blend effects to objects, which you can use to keyframe the position of the layer. So you can create the illusion of an object moving from being in front to being behind an object. You can also use another object as a clipping mask to define when your path should move behind or above another layer. You can also right-click a layer and enable the visibility range. This way you get the strip in your timeline where you can define the duration of the time your object is being shown, which is kinda interesting that it is optional, because it allows you to easily change the length of your animation without having to retouch all of your layers first. So quite a few cool things going on. But as far as I understand, there currently are no adjustment layers. Maybe you can somehow achieve a similar effect, but I didn't figure out how. Which brings me to the raster effects. Currently, these are very limited and you only have a few to choose from, but you have the important ones like blur, drop shadow, and motion blur. The motion blur, however, doesn't include any blur. It just creates instances of earlier frames and lowers the opacity, like the echo effect in After Effects. I will later explain why I think it behaves like that. But Friction does support custom OpenGL shader effects. There already is an existing plugin that has been ported from Envy to Friction, which adds quite a good amount of effects. Most of the effects are based off Netrun and Shader Toy. It definitely opens up a lot more compositing capabilities in Friction. You can add glow, distort, and stylization effects. Regarding the shader toy effects, I feel like most of them are a bit too specific to get use from them. Like, this is cool and all, but I don't really see myself using it. I would prefer being able to create more basic procedural textures like Perlin and Voronoi noise. I consider them pretty essential to be included in a future update. I tried porting them myself into Friction, but the documentation of it isn't too helpful, and since they are still considered to be experimental, they would probably stop working in the next update, so I gave up on that. There are also some minor things I would like to point out, so I'm going to present you Momo's list of minor stuff. In the settings, you can customize how much CPU cores and how much RAM Friction can use, and you can choose whether it should prefer your CPU or GPU. You can easily change the preview resolution to enhance the render speed. You can't hold Shift or other buttons to precisely change value sliders. When you play the animation, it will get pre-rendered and cached first, so you won't encounter laggy playbacks. When you scale an object, it changes the aspect of the outline. That's not good, by the way. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, the earliest evidence of friction goes back to 1581. The zero point of the canvas is at the top left, like in After Effects. So if you reset the location of an object, it will go there instead to the center. Overall, I would say that friction is still in an early development stage, which you will notice when working with it. There's definitely a lack of polishment, and some things don't feel completely thought till the end. Yet, you are already able to create animations in it, and that is the important part. I didn't experience too many bugs, but one thing that kept reoccurring was the viewport not receiving updates or objects becoming unselectable after playing the animation. Of course, the export of SVG animations for the web is a big part of friction, but I felt like it's also holding friction back. I think that's the reason behind the missing taper and brush presets from Envy, and also the reason why the motion blur isn't really blurring anything. We will have to see how this will be solved in the future. With the transformation hotkeys and the modifiers-like workflow, it does feel somewhat like working with Blender, but to fully capture the Blender experience, Friction would need to think of more efficient hotkeys for the tools and keyframes. The vector effects felt very capable and were fun to use, but some of them don't feel like they've been created with the usage for animations in mind. Like, it's cool that I can procedurally create an array of an object, but how can I animate the different duplicates individually? I feel like Cavalry did a better job of understanding what the tools could be used for. Of course, that's not a fair comparison, but as a consumer, you can get both softwares for free. Cavalry is extremely polished, but locks some features behind a subscription, and Friction is still at an early stage, but approaches things differently and is open source. I think it's likely that Friction can become really popular when continuously being updated. If you want to learn more about Cavalry, I coincidentally happen to have a video about it for you to dive in. That's all. Submarine to my channel.